Hi guys, Ryan here. Today I'm going to show you how to set up the Arduino IDE for the Raspberry Pi Pico. I'm then going to discuss some limitations of using the current Arduino IDE for the Pico. Without further ado, let's head over to the computer and get started. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is install the Arduino IDE. So to do this, we go to the arduino.cc site, come to the download sections, and for me, I'm going to install for Windows. So I just click on the installer once it's downloaded and just run through the steps. Okay, it might prompt you to install the drivers for the Arduino IDE, so we're just going to install these as well. Okay, and with that installed, we can close and load up the Arduino IDE. Okay, so with the Arduino IDE loaded, we're going to go Tools, Board, and then Board Manager. And then here, all we're going to do is just search for Pico. And it should come up with this Arduino Embed OS RP2040 boards. So here we can just click Install, and it will install everything it needs to for the Raspberry Pi Pico boards. Okay, at this point it's going to ask us if we want to install the Arduino drivers. We need to make sure we do this so that the Arduino IDE can interface with the Raspberry Pi Pico. Okay, and then once it's done, it should say installed next to the board. Just to have a script to test with, I'm going to come up to here and go Files, Examples, Basics, and Blink, just so we can do a basic flashing LED script. Here it's just going to use the built-in LED to turn it on, wait a second, turn it off again, and wait a second. So we're just going to have that flashing LED. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is plug in our Raspberry Pi Pico into our computer or laptop. And then we need to go to Tools, and under Board, make sure we select RP2040 boards and select the Raspberry Pi Pico. And then also we need to make sure that we select the correct port. Here it can see the COM port 3 is the Raspberry Pi Pico, so we're going to click on that. If for some reason you've got multiple ports there, you can open up Device Manager and then come to the port section. And then here you can unplug your Raspberry Pi Pico and you'll see that the port has disappeared, and plug it back in and you'll see for me port 3 come back up. So I know that port 3 is my Raspberry Pi Pico. So going back to Tools in the Arduino IDE, I've got Raspberry Pi Pico selected and the correct port. And then I'm just going to click Upload. So this is going to compile the sketch ready for the RP2040 chip and then push it to our Raspberry Pi Pico. So yeah, as you can see, it's done uploading, and looking at our Raspberry Pi Pico, it is flashing the onboard LED. If you do get an error message when you're trying to upload, then unplug your Pico, hold down the boot button and plug it back in again, holding down the boot button, reselect your port and compile and upload again, and it should work. That should only be for the first time that you use your Raspberry Pi Pico that you need to do that. Okay, in order to show you the limitations of the Raspberry Pi Pico, I've got an Arduino Mega, which I'm going to compile a script for. We can take a look at how long it takes to compile, as well as how much bytes it uses for the sketch and for the global variables. And then we'll compare this to the Pico to see the limitations of it. So I'm just going to open up a more complex script than the Blink. So we're going to go to the starter kit and we'll go for something like the touch sensor lamp. As you can see, this is using an external library as well, so we can see how that affects it. So with the Pico plugged in, I'm just going to change the board back again. And then here we can click upload, which will compile it and upload it to the Raspberry Pi Pico. Okay, so the first thing we can see here is this error message, which if you look it up online, just says that this capacitive sensor library doesn't support the Raspberry Pi Pico. So this is the first thing you're going to find when running scripts or trying to compile scripts for the Raspberry Pi Pico, that most of the libraries you use will not be compatible or will throw errors or won't run as you expect on the Pico. So let's try another script now and compare the two. I'm going to go for a more basic script this time. So yeah, we're just going to go to basics and we'll go for something like read analog voltage. Here I'm making sure that it's set to Raspberry Pi Pico and the correct port, and we're going to just click upload. Again, I'm just going to put on screen again how long it takes to compile, and then we'll take a look at how much memory and program storage it uses. Okay, as you can see, it's done uploading and it's used 81,000 bytes for the sketch and 53,000 bytes for global variables. Okay, just plugging in my Mega now, just going to change the board and then we're going to take a look at how long it takes to compile. So just clicking upload now, and I'll put the time on screen for how long it takes to compile. We can compare the two. So here we can see for the Mega, it only uses 3,300 bytes for the sketch, which is 24 times less than the Pico. And then for global variables, we're using only 200 bytes, which is over 250 times less than the Pico. So as you can see, the Raspberry Pi Pico compiler for the Arduino IDE is not as efficient, nowhere near as efficient as the compiler for Arduino boards. So that is the main limitation you're going to get by using the C or C++ language that you get through the Arduino IDE. Okay, so I think that Arduino releasing this compiler is a great move in the right direction. However, I wouldn't say it's production ready yet because of this inefficiencies that we've seen. It is good for hobbyists writing their own script, but anything that you need a fast processor or a low amount of memory usage, then I'm not so sure it's ready yet. One thing to note though is the large amount of memory and storage usage of this compiler wouldn't have as much effect on a Pico as it would on a Mega, just because the Pico does have 2 megabytes of flash storage compared to the only 256 kilobytes of something like the Mega. And it does have 264 kilobytes of RAM, whereas the Mega does only have 8 kilobytes. So the Pico is more forgiving as it's got more amount of space. So that is just one thing to note when looking at the limitations that I spoke about earlier. If you learned something from this video, make sure to like and subscribe for more future videos like it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.